Hi children, now we are going to see the topic properties of multiplication of a fractional numbers. Properties of multiplication, that we know. Properties of multiplication we know, no? What are all the properties? Yeah, order property, group property, yeah, property of 0, property of 1, okay. Now, here like that, here for fractional numbers also there are properties of multiplication. These properties are same for the natural number as well as fractional numbers, okay. The properties of multiplication of, okay, fractional numbers are similar to those of natural numbers, okay. What are all the properties that we'll see by doing the sums, okay. This is in page number 172, okay. Take in your textbook assignment 8, okay. Look here children, first fill in the boxes with the correct fraction, okay. Fill in the boxes with the correct fractions. Look here, take the first one. 3 by 8 into 1 by 5 is equal to 1 by 5 into, what will come here? The number 3 by 8, okay. 3 by 8, this called what? Order property. See, so if you change the order also in multiplication, the answer won't be changed, okay. The answer will be same only. So you should see 1 by 5, see after the equal sign 1 by 5 is there, but 3 by 8 is not there. So you should write that number as the missing number. Understood children, this is what it is called, order property, okay. Okay children, now we will do the fifth one. Look here, this is the group property. Look here, 1 by 8 into 3 by 4 into 4 by 5 is equal to 3 by 4 in dash into 3 by 4 into 4 by 5. So 3 by 4, 3 by 4 is there, 4 by 5, 4 by 5 is there, but 1 by 8 is missing. So you write that missing number. So after the equal sign, you should see the fractional numbers which is missing. Okay, you should write that which is missing, that is that will be in the left hand side. So you write that number, okay. Okay children, this property is called grouping property, group property. That means you can change, group the number and you can multiply, after that you do the remaining multiplication, okay. Now we will see the next second main. Look here, write the products. 1 by 9 into 0, that means this is equal to 0. So if you multiply any number by 0, or if 0 is multiplied by any number, the answer will be 0, the product will be 0, okay. Okay children, okay. So look here, fourth one, 0 into 5 by 9 is also 0. So 1 by 9 into 0 is also 0, 0 into 5 by 9 is also 0. This is, see, look here, the second one, 1 into 8 by 5, this is nothing but the, okay, property by 1, okay. 1 into 8 by 5, 0, what? 1 into 8 by 5 is nothing but 8 by 5. If you multiply any number by 1, you will get the same number, the number itself, okay. See, 1 by 11 into 1, what is it? It is 1 by 11 only, okay. So, these are all the what? Properties of whole number as well as natural number are same. Okay, children. Now, we are going to see the next topic. What is then? Multiplicative inverse. What? Multiplicative inverse or reciprocal. Reciprocal. Okay. That is when the product of two fractions is 1. Okay. If the two fractions product is 1, then each fraction is called the multiplicative inverse. Okay. Or the reciprocal of other fraction, okay. Then each fraction is called the multiplicative inverse or reciprocal of the other fraction. This is very important, you keep in mind. See, for example, we'll take 5 by 6 and 6 by 5, okay. 5 by 6 and 6 by 5. So, we are going to multiply it, 5 by 6 into 6 by 5, 5 by 6 into 6 by 5. As we know, 5 by 5 and 6 are how many? 30. 6 5 is 30. So, 30 by 30 is nothing but 1. No, 5 6 are 30, 6 5 are 30. So, 30 by 30 is 1 because, okay. So, 6 by 5 is the multiplicative inverse of 5 by 6 and 5 by 6 is the multiplicative inverse of 6 by 5. That means, inverse 5 by 6. What is the inverse of 5 by 6? 6 by 5. Okay, what is the inverse of 6 by 5? You should turn it. Inverse. You should write it inverse. Okay, understood children? We'll see one more example. Look here. 16 into 1 by 16 is equal to 1. Why 16 ones are 16 by 6, no? So, what is the inverse of 16? Inverse of 16 is 1 by 16. Inverse of 1 by 16 is 16. Understood children? So, okay. So, this is the reciprocal. Reciprocal of 16 is 1 by 16. Okay. And 1 into 1 ones are how much? 1. So, the multiplicative inverse of 1 is 1. So, what is the inverse of 1? This is very important. Keep in mind. The inverse of 1 is 1. And 0 does not have any inverse property because we do not have any number whose product with 0 is 1. Okay. So, 0 does not have inverse. Okay. Multiplicative inverse. Okay. Understood children. So, what is the multiplicative inverse of 1? 1 is nothing but 1 itself. Okay children. Take the next page. Assignment 9. What is the assignment? Write the multiplicative inverse, that means reciprocal of the following. Okay. See if 1 is done for you. 6 by 7. What is the inverse? 7 by 6. 7. What is the inverse? 1 by 7. You consider it 7 by 1. Okay. Then what is the inverse? 1 by 7. Okay. 7 is nothing but 7 by 1. Okay children. See 51 by 100. What is the inverse? 100 by 51. Okay children. Understood? So, in this way you should write. Okay. See, fifth sum I will do. 45. What is the inverse of it? 1 by 45. Because nothing is there in denominator means you consider it as 1. Okay. Understood? So, I will do the ninth one. Look here. What is the inverse of 1? 1 is 1. Okay. Because 1 by 1 is 1. 1 by 1 is 1. What is the inverse? 1 by 1. That is 1, 1. Okay, children. In this way, you should do the remaining sums. Okay.